Our response to our new song is based on Psalm 25. It can be found in your hymnal at number 744. Saying, it's really me, Ryan. It's difficult to capture the essence of a wonderful man in a few paragraphs, but Bill Davis embodied the definition of a true gentleman. He was and is a good soul who cared deeply about his friends and his family. While his manner was quiet and unassuming, through his strength of character and his witty banter, his true self was revealed. Bill was one of nine children in a close and loving family growing up in a two-bedroom house in East Peoria, Illinois. Bill often recounted how important it was to get to the dinner table on time. He shared a bedroom with two brothers on the front porch. After graduating high school, he went on a road trip with some friends, driving them so they could enlist in the military and so he could bring them home. After a night on the town, the end result was that all of his buddies, including Bill, enlisted in the Marines. He served in the Marines for 6 years, and then extended his stay for 14 more years in the Air Force. He stayed on at one point in place of his brother, going into combat. Bill further extended his service with the U.S. Post Office, where he walked over 40,000 miles during his career as a letter carrier. He made it a point to hand deliver mail right to the door, of elderly residents. My grandparents' connection began when Bill mooved in two doors down from Anime. It was as if the hand of God had brought them together, since they had both lost their spouses. Soon, there was a friendship born from their shared loss, and this started the journey as a two inseparable people. They loved taking vacations together and traveling to the islands with close friends. Anime and Bill were like the ocean tides, balancing and complementing each other. Anime's outgoing nature brought Bill to a new level, allowing him to experience new adventures with her, and providing the spark of incoming waves. And Bill, through his nature, provided the calming return of the tides and the reassurance during stormy times that life brought. While going through the pictures, my mother came across a Valentine's card that my grandfather gave to my grandmother. The verse is a true representation of their love and the life they shared. And it goes like this. For my wife, you know the story. Two people fall in love. They move their belongings into the same place and begin to make a life together. They discover that they don't fold their clothes the same way, and they can't always agree on whose turn it is to make coffee in the morning. But these are the little things, and because these two people love each other, they find a way to work it out. As time passes, there are other things. Money worries, illnesses, family crises. These are the big things. But because these two people love each other, they find a way to work them out too. And as each year goes by, they think about each other and all the fun times that they've shared and how their love has gotten them through the not-so-fun stuff. And they say to each other, thanks for everything, honey. I love you so much. Thanks for everything, honey. And I still love you very much. Love, Bill. In conclusion, my grandfather will be missed dearly. I hope to someday become half the man he was. People like my grandfather are truly one in a million. Anyone who was around him knew of his generosity, and his kindness, his work ethic, his humility, and his selflessness. So let us celebrate the life of Bill Davis, better known to me as Poppy. May he rest in peace.
Bodies are peacefully laid.
I also saw the homeless city.
On behalf of the parish of St. Margaret Mary's, we extend our pledge of prayers and sympathy to the family and friends of Bill. Bill hailed from East Peoria, Illinois, as Ryan mentioned, home of Caterpillar Tractors and Joe Girardi, Yankee manager. But we have a far more interesting person to speak about. If you were in Bill's company, he was classy, humble, quiet, a real gentleman. He was funny because he'd come out with this zinger. As his wonderful wife, Midge, was tutoring me in the ways of South Windsor, Bill would open up and say, nope, wrong person, yellow mailbox, number 37, Clifton. And he had been retired for quite the time. Bill would join me for a beer on the back porch to look at Anime's beloved sunsets. And he would come out with these wonderful things. He was a very bright man. And I think he found in Anime a very formidable woman. He was an attendant at daily mass. I think because he wanted to go, but I think it was better that he went rather than not go. A member of the Knights of Columbus, but very impressively, he served our nation. As you can see from the handsome picture of him in his Marine Corps uniform, he was also in the Air Force. When you think about that great hymn of the Air Force, off we go into the wild blue yonder, we can think about that today as he makes his path to heaven. And we can think about that years ago when he saw that very attractive neighbor down the street. Into that wild blue yonder he went. And he was never the same, nor were we the same. It's nice to have a power couple in South Windsor. If you saw from their early honeymoon photo, they were both strikingly good looking and only got better with maturation. The Marines, which he obviously, there's never a former Marine, they're always a Marine. I learned that the hard way. They're proud to claim the title of United States Marine to keep our honor clean. He did do that. Even as disease wore him down, he never lost a sense of dignity. He never failed to do his duty. If you go to Penn Station and turn around and face the post office there, you'll see along the frieze the inscription, "Neither snow nor rain nor heat nor gloom of night stops these couriers from their swift completion of their appointed rounds." It's a supposed motto of the post office, but actually comes from the father of history, Herodotus, speaking of the Persian couriers years, centuries ago, being men of integrity. Bill was a man of integrity. He was a man who not only was faithful as a Eucharistic minister, bringing that bread of everlasting life, he was also faithful to bingo, the eighth sacrament of the Catholic Church, and the only reason the parking lot is cleaned. He was a member of the American Legion, the VFW, the DAV, and the Elks. He liked you. He liked your company. He wanted to be with you, and he wanted to be with his Anna May as well. When we had an art show at the South Windsor Public Library, he was busting with pride with his grandson Ryan showing his objets d'art, and they were magnificent. And you could keep all the Michelangelos because Ryan didn't do that. He did this, and this was phenomenal. This evening at church, we have an art show as well. It's very fitting. I'm sure Bill would have been here and said, "It's not as good." That's called love. This man of substance, this man who loved his country, who loved his family, indeed loved his faith. We gather in such great numbers because he touched our hearts. He paid attention to us, and he listened very well. Didn't have much choice, but nonetheless. Anna May adored him, and he adored her. If you notice on the way in signing the register book, and I'll remind you, please sign the register book, because when Anna May goes through it, if your name isn't in there, you weren't here. She's Irish. Be careful. But if you'll notice right next, there's two green mittens, and I thought people always leave things in church all the time, glasses and mittens and umbrellas. But no, these mittens were mittens for holding hands. They're sewn together so they could hold hands in their wonderful walk on the beach. When they went down to Madison one time, they said, "Oh, you have to meet us at Madison," and they were in their glory. They loved to be at the beach. They loved the sunsets. They loved to be with each other, holding hands. We now bid farewell to Bill so that he may reach out and hold God's hand. But we know that the ties of friendship grow even tighter with our passing, that communion of saints, that connection of spiritual friendship, that cloud of witnesses in that wild blue yonder awaits Bill. We give thanks to Almighty God for having had him in our lives. We give thanks to Almighty God for Anna May sharing him with us. And we thank him for example of faith and faithfulness. May the noble soul of William Dale Davis rest in peace.
What a time, and a time for grieving. took root and